Okay, welcome to the astronaut class of 2017. It's been a crazy couple of days for you guys, what with the announcement coming here. You've had a lot of interviews so far, and we've gotten to know just a little bit about you, but I thought we'd do something a little bit more fun today by doing two truths and a lie. So if you're not familiar with the game, each one of you has a piece of paper, and you've written down two true statements about yourself and one false statement. So let's see how well you know each other now and see if you can guess which thing is the lie. I think we'll start by just going in alphabetical order. It seems like this is how we did the announcement and how we've been doing most things. So Kayla, let's start with you. Your two truths and a lie.
Awesome. Love going first. It's always a good thing here. So my first statement here is I've never lost a game of charades.
Lie.
My second statement is I predicted my little sister's birth. And my third statement was I was once part of a competitive wine tasting team.
I believe that.
It's out there.
Have you ever played charades?
Can't answer that.
What's the ROE on question asking? Yeah. Outright guess?
What do you mean you predicted the birth? Like,
can't answer that either.
That there was going to be a baby?
That's without definition. I think that's pretty loosely. I don't have a sister to count.
Charades.
She's probably never played charades.
I think that's the line.
You guys got it right. I will. It was based on a truth. I've actually never lost a game of Pictionary. So if anybody's up to challenge that run, and I've played a lot of Pictionary, so. But good job, guys.
Turn off the cameras. We're playing Pictionary.
Definitely need to know more about the competitive wine tasting. That sounds awesome.
So I went to the University of Cambridge for grad school, and it's an interesting place. I call it Disney World for nerds because it's just like not real life. But one of their varsity sports there is blind wine tasting, wherein you do a red, first a white round, then a red round, where they pour you six glasses of wine from like wine bottles and bags so you can't see anything about it. And then you have to identify a bunch of like nerdy characteristics, like tasting notes, how much alcohol, sugar content, acidity level, where it was grown, et cetera. I will say that I did not make the varsity squad due to actually drinking my wine at practice as opposed to spitting it out. So, but it was a good time for sure.
That sounds awesome. Okay, so next we'll move on to Zena.
Okay, let's see. First of all, I absolutely hate mushrooms. I will not eat them. I will not touch them. Two, I am really good at bowling. And three, I'm really good at etch-a-sketching. I've never broken 100. I'm so bad.
So etch-a-sketching, what's the coolest thing you've drawn on an etch-a-sketch?
I did a portrait of Bob Dylan in high school that was really good. And then at the very end, I decided to write his name, but I forgot the L in Dylan and I had to do it over again.
Oh, no.
It was really sad.
Are you good at staircases?
Yes,
that's probably the best thing.
Exactly.
I can
do. There's no undo button. Yeah, circles are still tricky though.
Awesome. Okay, Raja, let's move on to you.
All right. So, I used to slice deli meat for a living. I met Neil Armstrong when I was 5, and my flight lead stopped me from flying into North Korea.
Deli meat.
Neil Armstrong.
Deli meat. Deli meat.
Deli meat.
Neil Armstrong.
Only because they asked yesterday if anybody had ever met Neil Armstrong.
Okay. Yeah. How fast can you slice a deli meat?
Pretty fast. My wife and I actually worked at Hy-Vee for a while, and we sliced deli meat in the deli section. She actually lost the tip of her finger on the deli slicer, so yeah.
Wow.
But reattached, so everything's good.
Right. Very cool, and definitely need to know the story behind almost flying into North Korea.
So there's a restricted area, and there's obviously a lot of airfields in that area, and so I was a young wingman, and we were doing practice target attacks, and I was, we were just, you know, split from each other, and I was doing a talk on, we call it, to an airfield, and I was, you know, I was getting really close. I'm like, man, I can break out and counting things on the runway, and all of a sudden my flight lead realizes that that is not a South Korean airfield that I'm describing, that is a North Korean airfield, and calls me south before anything worse happened. But yeah, I was you know, fat, dumb, and happy, like, you know, into the scenario, like, yeah, you got this, you know, describing everything I saw on the ground, which was actually really something over there on the ground, but yeah.
So. Well, now you have an amazing amount of flight experience, too, so I'm sure some things you're going to learn from. Awesome. Okay, so Matt, you're up.
All right.
All right, my three things here. I have climbed 10 14ers in Colorado. I rode on the crew team in college. And I won a gift wrapping competition during the holiday season at the Container Store.
I really hope the container thing is true. That would be awesome.
I feel like he can't row.
He was on the row. That's true.
Yeah. Climb more. All right, all right.
Which one is it?
Also climbed 10.
What was the first? He was a rower.
The climbing 10, 14.
What's the guess?
In Colorado.
Official guess.
14ers is the lie. Yeah.
All right.
I've climbed zero. I've only driven up them.
I climbed one, and it's a pretty funny story.
So I'm guessing you have a record for the gift wrapping competition then, right?
No, I was just holiday season, and I think in D.C., we were, with my wife at the Container Store, and they happened to have a competition for you could win a gift certificate, and I kept refusing to join, but my wife got me into it, and then I won it. We got an awesome $20 gift certificate.
I'm surprised you haven't climbed any 14ers, though. That's surprising.
Yeah, no, growing up in Colorado, not having climbed a 14er is pretty unusual.
Okay, well, let's move on to Bob.
All right, here we go. I reordered these, so your philosophy on which one's the lie doesn't apply. That's right. So I met my wife in grad school. I went to college on a track scholarship, and I got hit by a truck while flying an airplane. Yeah, wife in grad school. Didn't meet her there.
Met you her gotta tell the truck story, man.
Always is. So I was flying a little Cessna 152, tiny little airfield, uncontrolled airfield up in Pennsylvania. And there's a road literally about 10 feet from the end of the runway. They have these little flashing lights that say yield to low flying aircraft. And I'm sitting in the left side of the airplane where you sit when you're by yourself. And I'm coming down final approach. And next thing I know, I hear this thump, and I'm looking out the side of the airplane at the runway. I go around and I'm trying to figure out what just happened. I look over my shoulder. I see a black disc bounce and hit a building. I look out, and there's no wheel on the left side. And so after a little troubleshooting and talking to the guys on the ground at the FBO, they all come out, standing by the runway. I fly by, and they're like, okay, you have just a strut on your left side and nothing on the right side. Oh, still have no idea what happened at this point. I just know all that stuff flew off the airplane at some point. Anyway, landed on the runway. I mean, it's a Cessna, so you land at 45 knots, something like that. So touchdown, it spins around in the airplane. We all get out, and we're standing around like a bunch of hillbillies kind of. Oh, man, that was cool. And this tractor trailer comes driving down, pulls over the 10 feet of grass, drives up the runway, and he goes, "You hit my truck." And he lifts up the back, and we look in, an empty trailer. And you can see he skidded right across the top, one of the spars that holds the skin on the top of the wow. truck. I skidded right across it.
Wow. So it was 6 inches. Lie then, because you hit the truck.
Not true. That was for insurance purposes. So the truth was twisted.
This is on TV.
So they now have a displaced threshold down there at that airport, 300 feet down, so that there's no hazards on the thing. So that's all due to me.
You have an amazing
or the
story,
truck driver, actually. It's all due to him. So it was funny, though. He's calling his insurance company, and they go, okay, we had an accident. And they say, okay, what's the vehicle type? And he's like, looks at me, and I'm like, Cessna 152. They're like, we don't have that in our database.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let's move on to Woody.
All right. So in keeping with Matt's theme, I've climbed one of the seven summits. I built model rockets in high school, and I can do a standing front flip.
You're too tall for a front flip. Your rotational nerves is too big. No chance.
Woody can tell
you. I think
I've seen him do it.
You had to have built up with a rocket.
He was known for rocket making as a kid. Yeah. So.
Back to front flips.
Long circles of rocket makers. Actually, BK said something about him making rockets.
Oh, okay. The summit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Summits. summit.
It's the front flip. Can't do a front flip.
Physics.
The rotational inertia.
Too tall.
Can you do a backflip?
I cannot.
Oh. Not even off the diving board?
Never tried. It just seems really scary.
So what summit did you climb?
I did Denali.
Denali? All right. Very cool.
Oh, very nice.
Very cool. Okay, Jonny, you're up.
So, number one, I wrote, enlisting in the Navy was the best decision of my life. Number two, I got in trouble overseas after being on the phone next to a generator after a mortar attack and not being there for the headcount. And I am a hot dog eating champion of my local high school.
Hot dogs.
Joining the Navy.
I think the first one,
I think
the marriage is the first one.
Yeah, that sounds like a
trick.
Damn it, we just burned
that
spot.
No, we'll let you get a pass on
that. Tell the truth, Johnny. Tell the truth, which was the lie? Hot dogs.
Is that the hot dogs? Yeah, that was the lie. I am now in trouble.
It's a sad puppy face. You figured it out. Love it.
So that generator story.
I definitely got in trouble with my platoon for, okay. Where's Johnny? And I was outside on the phone. So.
Oh, man. Okay, well, glad you're okay. All right, Robb, you're up.
All right, so inspected a rocket booster while it had liquid oxygen on board, skied off the summit of Denali wearing a Superman cape, or went rock climbing with a broken ankle while wearing an astronaut helmet.
Ooh. What was the second one?
Skied off the summit of Denali wearing a Superman cape.
I'll go with that one.
You guys are too easy.
So what kind of cape was it?
that was the lie.
What was the last one again?
I went rock climbing with a broken ankle while wearing an astronaut helmet.
Why?
Why not?
I didn't realize it was broken. It just kept giving out on me.
No, why did you? Yeah,
you gotta be safe. No, one of those padded astronaut helmets like you see in the costume store. And my buddies and I, we always like when we go climbing, you know, having some sort of gag with the affair, whether it be some sort of silly costume, I guess. And that day it was the astronaut helmet. So.
Unbelievable. Okay, that was awesome. Jasmin, you're up.
All right, I'm an aunt to an incredibly cute and well-mannered 4-year-old little girl. In college, I was a member of the varsity basketball, lacrosse, volleyball, and cross-country teams, and I was pushed down a flight of stairs by my brother when I was 2.
You don't seem like you'd be well-behaved.
I think it's something the second one. I think you're
one of those is fake in the list.
The list
too, it's
sport.
Too many. That would be weird.
Or maybe her niece is not well behaved.
I think she really did all the sports.
Was it you that's well behaved at 4?
No.
I didn't do that many sports in 3 seasons. Yeah, you can.
Oh, you can do
but
it.
There's many
my niece.
Oh, okay. All right. I thought it was you.
My 4-year-old niece.
Yeah, sports.
Once she gets that varsity letter, she just moves on to the next sport.
I'm gonna go with stairs. I think she pushed her brother down the stairs.
The werewolf skills coming out.
So which one is it?
I don't have a 4-year-old niece.
Anymore.
That was so disgusting.
I pushed her down the stairs.
So how did you make time for all the sports?
I played volleyball my freshman year, volleyball and lacrosse my freshman year, cross country, basketball and lacrosse my sophomore year, and then basketball and lacrosse my junior and senior years.
Wow. Very impressive.
That's awesome.
I believed all along, John.
Okay, so we have about 2 more minutes, so let's go on to Loral.
Other way. All right, so I eat tacos at least half the days of the week.
Respect.
In middle school, I used to get in trouble for talking out loud in class all the time. And I've once won a no-shower marathon.
Middle school.
Middle school.
Tacos. Does that mean 4 days a week or 3 days a week?
Three or four days.
It's a
technicality.
Yeah, technicality.
Well, welcome back to Houston. This is awesome. You got their pick of really no shower contest?
Yeah, so I rode on the crew team, and my freshman year, the women's team decided to do a no shower marathon. So starting, it was like the end of October. We just stopped showering. So we were going to practice like once or twice a day and going to class and everything. And
we're classmates.
Yeah, it was pretty rough by the end of it. We actually called it. There were two of us still left. So I'm a co-champion.
But how many days did you make it?
It's like 21 days.
Wow. All right, well, you'll be well prepared for space because you can actually do the wet wipe showers when you're in there. So you'll be ready.
Yeah, no wet wipes.
Okay, so Frank. No wet wipes.
All right. So I started dating my wife in high school. I've flown a handmade Russian aircraft while deployed. And I once owned 4 ducks, a rabbit, and 6 guinea pigs at the same time.
What was the second one?
I once flew a handmade Russian aircraft while deployed.
Is it a helo?
I
think the animals are true.
I know the ducks are true.
Yeah,
I think so. We're the
wife. What was the wife?
I started dating my wife in high school.
They started dating in high school.
I believe that one.
We'll go with the animals. I'll go with the animals.
I'm sitting next to you.
Yeah, no, it was a Hungarian aircraft. So.
That's a lot of animals.
Yeah, so we had 3 guinea pigs. 3 female guinea pigs. Somehow one of them got pregnant and had babies, and so afterwards we had 6 guinea pigs. Yeah. That's how that works. Little sneaky guy.
Okay, Jessica, you're last.
So my guilty pleasure is watching American Ninja Warrior. I eat extremely slowly, and I won an Olympic medal.
The Olympic medal in your bio.
It's the first one's the
Olympic
line.
Olympic medal in what?
I think it's the Ninja Warrior.
Ninja Warrior is awesome. Warrior.
I did not like that. I think she did win.
I think she won a medal.
I think she did too. I think it's the first one, the line. What was the first one?
I watch American Ninja Warrior.
You're a fast eater. You said the second one's the
slow eater. She is a slow eater. She's taken to-go boxes everywhere we've gone.
What do you think? So Ninja Warrior?
The lie is that I won an Olympic medal, but I appreciate that you guys took your time. Awesome. Yeah.
I'm like, it would have been amazing.
But you did win a couple of rugby championships, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Very cool. Okay. Guys, thanks so much for taking the time to play this game, get to know you a little bit better. For our viewers and listeners, if you want to know the real biographies of these guys, the real long, informative ones, just go to nasa.gov/2017astronauts. We have the bios of each one of these guys up here, and you can learn more about them. So, guys, it's been a pleasure talking with you today, and best of luck on your transition to moving to Houston and to start training. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.